How to be a good tour leader. Now, tour leaders vary in experiences and personalities. So, when you go on a tour, it's very difficult for you to experience a consistent level of service. It's just like doctors. You can't expect all doctors to be providing the same level of service. Now I have this 74-year-old traveler with me. He says that he went to see a doctor with self-diagnosis of knee tendon sprain or knee ligament sprain. The doctor examined him without bothering to do a blood test for uric acid and diagnosed him as having gout. Give him the medicine and nowadays, as you know, Singaporeans are much more knowledgeable, and this retiree has those type of comprehensive blood tests every 2 years. By comprehensive means everything, including cancer markers and so he's quite aware that definitely this diagnosis of gout based on the doctor's statement was a misdiagnosis, so he didn't take the medicine. How old is this doctor? I asked him. He says it's around 50. So as you can see, even an old hand can be quite misdiagnosed a case of gout based on examination of knee, the physical examination of the knee, joint in a 74-year-old man. Now back to the tour leader's quality. I think the first quality will be high energy, because much is expected of the time in planning, telephoning the local agents, and getting to accommodate changes. Certain things happen, and then the important thing is to communicate with the Singaporean travelers. Now, Singaporean travelers are quite demanding. Even in my group of 22, one of them would be quite vocal about not wanting any videos to be played in a bus during those long journeys. And she was so vocal that saying it was so noisy. But as you can see, yeah. So you can see even this tour leader is high energy. He wakes up so early. This is only before 7 a.m. And to make sure that everything is in order in the breakfast table, which is now it's only 6:45 a.m. And breakfast starts at 7, so you can see that she probably has not enough sleep. Now some tour leaders even overslept. I have one case, and everybody had the breakfast and were waiting in the bus. Finally he came. We were waiting about 10 minutes inside this bus. I believe was in the US tour after Niagara Falls, and so one of the young couples lodged a complaint against him. So as you can see, it is difficult being in this line, having to take care of 22 different personalities for 12 days. Also, high energy is needed, dedication. For example, this tour leader, really, the sun you saw, woke up so early before most of the 22 travelers to check on the breakfast. Arrangements. This is quite a rare thing because, from what I know, many tour leaders can't get up so early. Then the other characteristic is, she does phone up every room after they have checked in to find out whether they have any problems or not with their room. And so, you have 22. You really got to phone up 22 travelers, or at least 10, at 2 per room. This is like a follow-up for the doctor. You got to follow up after surgery. But as you know, most doctors don't bother to follow up. Or even vets, they don't bother. So, this is a rare trait. And of course, the customer remembers you for that following up, as showing that you care about them. Show that you care before they will do business with you or referral to you. So this is one of the lessons I learned from this traveling. If you don't care about your clients, why should they come back to you for business? But in this case, even the tour leader, especially those who are professionals, they depend on referrals, and they have targets to meet and bills to pay. So by showing that you care, like giving medicine when they're coughing, and caring about their health, and of course, for the vocal minority who wanted no video shows inside the coach, she was quite firm and said that we're out here to relax and enjoy ourselves. So there will be some who want to watch the movie on the long drive. And so she explained, communicated well, and the vocal minority, the woman, said that, well, if it was not too loud, she wouldn't mind. And that's how she solved this objection from a vocal minority. And overall, communications with the travelers is very important, and I think this is where the personality comes in. Well, she does tell stories while inside the coach on the long journeys of her personal experiences, give good advices on the gypsies, those who are out to distract and steal from travelers, and relate her experiences, stories, storytelling, which I think is very important for a tour leader, because it can be quite long coach rides. We've stopped over at 2 to 3 hours, so in between, actually, for this package tours, the old folks have nothing to do. Of course, being a bilingual, English and Mandarin, she was able to communicate much better with these Singaporeans. Many of them actually speak Mandarin. And at the end of the day, I will rate her as top-notch in this, in her profession. And this is one of those outstanding tour leaders one will ever meet. High energy, dedicated, and able to let the travelers know that they get more than what they pay for. Example, a city tour which he personally led in I think was in one of the Granada, yeah, in Granada. It was not in the itinerary, but she did all the travel to bring everybody on the city tour. So overall, this was a surprising journey of Spain and Portugal and Andorra. And I hope she would do well in her profession. October 4th, 2014, Lisbon, breakfast at 7 a.m, going out at 8:30 a.m. Portugal, the last 3 days of the Spain, Andorra and Portugal tour.